By your mic to tell you along with the Big Chief and the Cannon. Hey, this is our favorite segment each and every week. It's Martin's Dare, what he's going to do each and every week. And hey, listen, we got to give him a big round of applause because, listen, he had to work overtime this weekend with the hurricane out in the Gulf and keeping everybody informed about what was going on. And Martin, you had a nice experience Sunday. Got to see what was going on before the game, so we understand you had a pretty good experience.
So wait, you were that, Martin, were you tired? You had to drink one of those five-hour energy things or what? Because I know you're working overtime.
Nice tea.
Before we go on, let's pan the camera over here. Because not only was I wearing an Aaron Brooks jersey, I saw Lester Beamer, look, the guy in the dapper yellow and the Cody, he was wearing a Gary Quazzo jersey from way back when.
Yeah, but so Lester would probably have that jersey.
Right. I didn't feel bad.
That was a
Heath Shuler. That might be worse than Aaron Brooks, I can promise you. But watch the monitor and look at the captions and read them real closely, and let's see if I was able to win another one. Here we go.
Well, another week here on Saints on the Bayou. And as you can tell, it's an overcast day. And I'm a little depressed today because the bet this week, of all things, I got to wear an Aaron Brooks jersey. Need to start a comedy show. Holy cow! You got me an
orchestra.
Yeah, man. That's very good. Look.
Offered me a beer a while ago. You think I can get that beer?
Aaron Brooks, right? Oh yeah, man. I'll get you a beer. No problem. Here, you want it?
Yeah.
I had it. I was getting out.
Check this out.
Damn, that thing looks like it's on fire.
Golden Metal, watch it. Oh, that was a good kick.
Yes, sir. I'm going to pick you up here, because this is going to be a collector on the number two. It's always a collector.
decided that y'all have the greatest job in the world. I'm going to drive from home and get paid for it, record a bunch of drunk people having fun, and then I'm going to go to the game. And then I'm going to record more drunk people after we win.
You're not drunk, though.
Not at all.
Did I hear you right? Y'all got an Aaron Brooks bobblehead? Are you serious?
Yeah, we do.
Ain't no. Ain't no.
In church right now.
Yeah?
I'm from Cutoff, man.
Cutoff?
Salvafoos, class 01.
Yeah.
Hey, you know Bobby Hebert?
Oh, I know him well.
Just between me and you, that's my real dad. If you talk to him, I don't want anything. I don't want money. I don't want nothing. I just
that's
want
your real dad?
Bobby, I don't want child support. Bobby Hebert is my real father.
Real?
Yeah, class of 77, state championship, prom night. Don't worry, I don't want anything.
Here we go. Get in, boy. Get on board. Come on, y'all. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. We're going to see Bobby Hebert. Let's go. WWL table. I'm going to win my bet. I'm going to win an Aaron Brooks jersey. I know it sucks big time, but I'm going to win the bet. Bobby! Bobby J! I win the bet!
You're very nice!
Hey, they've been dog cussing me for 2 hours.
All right. Well, like the Saints, Martin's undefeated on the dares. And you know what? Because of all the coverage, I know he's wore out. We're going to give him a bye this week. Just like an NFL team has a bye,
right.
We're going to give him a bye this week.
Well, I think that's a fair.
No, I don't know. When you're undefeated, you get the prima donna syndrome. And so hopefully after the bye, he doesn't come back with a loss. But, I mean, we put the pressure on him because he might start slacking, you know. But undefeated, yeah, you got to give him a break, so we'll give him a bye. But, you know, we don't want Martin to be a prima donna, but I've been watching him lately. After kicking the way he kicked, I mean, he still thinks if Corny misses a few more field goals, they're going to come sign him up.
I might. But, Bobby, you look pretty good in that dress. What you say? Are you really want to wear that dress this year?
God, you know what? When I first said that I would do that, you know, you come in trying to make everybody happy. You say, yes, I'll do that. Yes, I'll do anything. All of a sudden in 06, I'm like, shoot, they won game away from the Super Bowl. I'm going to have to wear a dress. To the station, they had, I'm telling you, over 200 dresses were sent to WWL. Boxes of shoes, like high heels and all. I'm like,
yeah, but how many of them would have fit that feet?
No, I don't. I have 11 and a half, 12 size foot, but I have a wide foot. I don't know if I could see a big woman like that. That got me. Or I should say, I don't want to see her. She has a high heel like that. but you know what? I'd be glad to wear it if the Saints go to Super Bowl, because that's why Buddy DiLiberto had said, yeah, I'll wear a dress if the Saints go to Super Bowl, because he thought it never would happen. But that was before, really, Coach Payton and Drew Brees came on board.
And there you go, bragging about your feet again. Huh, Dickie? Dickie Mikey's always bragging about his feet.
Well, no, it's hard to find a high heel.
We're going to keep it PG. That's not all he bragging about.
And Mark, to show you how crazy it was, they had, I'm telling you, 300 people call me up. They had a group called Buddies Broads. And they were planning on me. They had all this schedule. We're going to march in every parade and all that. I said, no, I'm not marching every Mardi Gras parade. I'm doing it one time, probably a block on Padres. And then that's it. No, they thought it was going to be some kind of club, and we're going to have meetings and all kind of. And I said, no. I said, I'm not a drag queen. Come on. I said, I'm not doing all that.
Hey, I want to thank my mom for the jersey, Mom. I stained it up pretty good. I hope you don't mind. But it was just part of the gig, all right?
You heard what she said. You left all that oyster juice on it.
Well, but thanks for letting me use that. All right. 9-0, baby.
9-0. Hey, we'll be back more with Saints on the Bayou.